The wire removal effect was added into HitFilm Pro 2017 back in Update 1, but it hasn't yet received a dedicated tutorial. Today we'll be looking at this simple shot and removing the pieces of string that are holding up the object. This effect is not currently possible in Express. I'm Javert Valbar for inScapedigital.com. Let's get started. You can download this video clip to practice from the link in the description. The first step is to track the movement of my footage. This will lessen the amount of keyframing I'll have to do. Create a point, then highlight your video layer and click this plus icon next to Tracks. This is standard motion tracking procedure. I'm not doing anything unique for this shot. There are numerous tutorials out there for motion tracking, so I'm just going to kind of brush over it. I tracked my footage using a space on the lightsaber, then applied it to my point layer. Drag the wire removal effect directly onto your video layer. Drop down the start properties and set the use layer to the point. You can use either the position values or the crosshair in the viewer to set the starting point in the correct spot. I'll do the same for the end position. In the case of this footage, I can copy and paste the start position onto the end, and raise the Y value until it's off screen. I'll shift it a little bit to the right to cover the string. I'm going to zero out these three values and explain how they work. This is pulled directly from the online HitFilm manual, which has come in handy over the years to clear up any questions I have about effects in the software. The wire removal effect draws a line over the wire, between the start and end points, and repaints that line using background info from the video. This slider sets the width of the line. Adjust it so that it covers the whole wire that needs to be removed. The gradient softens the edges of the repainted line to blend it into the background. Try to raise this setting only as much as the scene requires. Setting it too high may create a ripple as the wire moves. This setting adds a reflection at the center of the line, which may help it to blend into the scene better. These three settings are going to vary depending on your clip. The process for the back wire was identical, although I did find it a bit harder to erase the string completely. I think it had to do with this out-of-focus color gradient section of the wall behind it. If you're interested in how I color graded the shot, be sure to check out my recent tutorial on cinematic lighting. Let me know if you have any questions below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.